So in this session, we are going to learn about configuring SMS gateway email, which we have seen again. I'll just revise that once. Plus how to configure SMS templates for different screen. Basically, we are integrating for, let's say for after a sales bill, the thank you message should go to the customer. How can we configure this? Likewise, we can configure SMS across different screens with a personalized template. The customer will get a message saying, "Dear Mr. Rajputana Enterprises," or "Dear Mr. XYZ from Rajputana Enterprises, your last bill number was this much. This was the bill amount, this was the bill date. And if you want, you can even add total outstanding is this much. Thank you for buying from us." One simple message after a sales bill. To do this, first we'll have to configure the SMS gateway. To configure SMS, first we'll have to enable the module. It's called Max Alerts. That will enable first. The customer should have this add-on license in order for this facility to be configured. This is one. Second, the client should have, or we should create a customer SMS account first. We have an SMS gateway in which we configure the SMS account through which the SMS goes. Okay. So we have a demo account here. So I'll just have to log out and log in once. After enabling the module, I'm just going to file menu and I'm going to the SMS gateway setup. So you have SMS template design here, you have an email template design also option available. To configure email gateway, you are just going to users and you are selecting an admin user or whichever user is there. For that, we have already done an email setup here. You just mention their name, email ID and all the details. For example, email setup, it's in email setup, we do the email configuration through which the email templates will be routed, all email communications will be routed. Same way for SMS, we are going to this SMS gateway setup. I just have a demo account with me. Here we have to, generally we are using the DND SMS route because the messages will be going to the DND numbers also. We have two routes here. Normal SMS, which are promotional for marketing purpose, and DND SMS for information. Only on DND numbers, the promotional messages are generally blocked on do not disturb numbers. DND means do not disturb. So here we have DND SMS route in which the messages will even be routed to the DND numbers also. Whoever has DND activated on their mobile phones, still the message will get delivered to them. But only thing is, message should be an information message. It should not be marketing. Now SMS length. What should be the message length restricted here? So we can have up to 480 characters. One message would be around 160 characters. So here we can have up to 480 we can connect. And a sender ID also will block it for the customer, saying we have this Max SW. Default header for any message, if you want to predefine some header, like dear user, or if you want your website name or something to be configured. In the footer, also you can have a signature like kind of thing. So this will be appended at the bottom of the message automatically. Same in header, you can have any greeting if required, and that will automatically get added at the top of the message, and then the message, and then followed by the footer. And any remarks if you want to give, you can give. So I'll just remove this footer for now, this is not required. And I'll save this. After saving, we'll just open this route again and we'll just see if SMS balance is available. So it shows there are 4,371 messages left in this account, which means the gate that we have configured is correct. It is able to collect the data from there. I mean, it's able to link and find out the account details and fetch the data. So likewise, we can have multiple SMS gateways also. This is the default one. We can have multiple SMS gateways and link or use different gateways for different purposes. For example, this gateway has the sender ID as Max SW. If required, we can have one more gateway with Max Accounts, Max ACC kind of thing. Currently in India, this SMS sender ID has to be 6 letters only, 6 alphabets, nothing less, nothing more. No numbers, no special characters, nothing will be accepted, only 6 alphabets. Okay. So whenever any customer needs to get an SMS configured, first thing we ask them is the sender ID that is required. When customer says if sender ID is big or small, nothing is acceptable. If they say only three letters are required, even three is not accepted. Minimum, maximum, everything is six alphabets, capital letters. That's it. Okay. So after configuring this, we can just see how do we configure the template here. I just go to SMS template design. I can select a template name saying a thank you message, or I can just give sales thank you message. Whether should it ask a confirmation to the user on the screen or not? That's the first option which is saying. Whether it should ask a message to the user saying do you want to send SMS? If user gives yes, then only message will go, otherwise it won't go. So if you want that confirmation box, then you can tick this. Otherwise, if the tick is not there, message will directly keep going silently in the background. Then it is saying which screen do you want this template to be linked to. So here we can link it to sales voucher. See, there are all the screens available here throughout the software. And along with each screen, there are it can even be a POS voucher for retail, or it can be a sales voucher for invoicing. So all the screens of the software are linked here. Against what action do you want this message to be triggered? When user saves the transaction, do you want this message? Or when someone edits this, you want a message? See, that we can even configure in such a way that if a user on the counter deletes any message or edits any message, a silent message will go to the owners or the managers at the background. So they are aware that how many messages or how many transactions have been edited or how many has been deleted. Anyways, for this sample demo, we can just give for save. During a save action, a message should be sent. To whom should it be sent? It can be sent to administrator, basically the admin user of the system on the software. If there are multiple admin users, it will go to all. Ensuring that you have the admin user mobile number entered in the user master. If there is only one admin user and yet you want to send messages to multiple people, then you need to configure comma separated mobile numbers. For example, many of these stores might have multiple partners, but they are not accessing the system, so their user is not created. Neither the owner generally accesses the system in case if someone else is there. In that scenario, you can configure one admin user along with three mobile numbers comma separated, and the messages will go to all three if this admin is ticked. Second option is account. Account is the customer directly. On whose name we are mentioning the bill, to that person the message will go if the mobile number is entered in the master. If mobile number is not there, even the account is ticked, but if the mobile number is not mentioned, the message will not go. To the salesperson.
We have to add in the account, we have to get the customer, is it?
Yes. And the customer master, we have to mention the mobile number. If there is more than one mobile number, mention a comma separate mobile number.
So randomly they cannot send message like this.
That is a separate thing. That's a separate skin. Well, I'll show you. But currently we are seeing is linking or integrating with any of the screen while the sales transaction. There's other screen options available wherein we can send bulk SMS to external contacts also, as well as all the customer in one shot also. We'll see that. Then messages, whether message should go to the salesperson. While billing, you are selecting a salesperson on the screen. So there are many scenarios where an agent is bringing in a customer and a bill is happening to the customer. Agent also knows that this bill is for 1 lakh rupees or 50,000 rupees or whatever it is. So they keep track for their own commissions. So whether the salesperson should also receive a message. Then the user. What is this user? User means the current logged in user, whether he should receive a message or not. Then we have one thing called supervisor. Who is the supervisor? In user master, we have a parent user concept where we can define a hierarchy for a complete organization or for a company. So each user will have a parent user. For example, let's say Subit is reporting to me. So for in Mac software, Subit will have a username password, I'll have a username password. And for Subit user, you can create my name as a parent. So whenever Subit bills or when there's any billing happening in the name of, when Subit is logged in and billing, I'll receive a message. Admin might not, or the administrator may not require all the messages to be sent to them, but at least the manager should receive a message for all the transactions. In that scenario, the user's parent user would be a supervisor, he will receive a message. So these are the few options that we have. If you tick all, everyone will receive a message for every sales bill. Okay. Now how do we define a template? There's a clear message saying control enter for the next line. Okay, I can just give like, if you want to design a personalized, if it's just a thank you message, you can just give a thank you for buying from us and save it. But if you want more information onto this, we have an fields to be inserted option here. The same options are applicable for email template design also. Here I'm just mentioning, let's say dear, and I want a contact name. So I can just mention account name, or I just can mention contact name, contact person. I can click insert. Dear contact person, Thank you. Or you can even have some account name. Like dear Mr. XYZ from Rajputana Enterprises, for example, in our scenario. You need to mention the contact person also. If it's not there, it will remain blank here. Okay. Thank you for visiting our store or something. Then we can have just the control enter. Last invoice number. Here all the transaction fields would be available. For us, it would be like we have voucher number, invoice date, you can even have time also if required. This amount. If you want LR number, LR dates, see many of these clients are even doing a they are sending the dispatch information at the end of the day. They will put all the bills at the end of the day, they will pack all the goods and they will transport to different lorry people. So with every lorry people, they will have the LR number and LR date coming in along with the transport name. So they will update all this in the sales register, and through sales register we need to design a template in the sales register screen. This is for a thank you message for the bill. When we have that in the sales register, all the customers can receive a direct message, their customers basically. Our clients' customers can receive messages for the dispatches in one shot. Everyone will receive that, they'll know that this is the LR number, this is the transport company and date on which the goods have been dispatched. And they'll get their own estimate saying the goods might, or they know that which transport company they have to contact for the receipt of the goods. Otherwise they have to inform or send an email with the information every day. So once the SMS is there, it actually reduces a lot of work and increases a lot of productivity. In one click itself, the message directly goes in the hands of the users. That's it. We can just save this template. The small information that we have filled here. Here we have all the information, purchase order number, purchase order date, LR number, LR date, all the fields which are available on the billing screen other than the product details. Here we are not able to send the product details. The bill is big, means it will accept, I mean it will exceed 480 characters also. For that we are designing something different now. But for now what we have is the bill related information, just as in summary, will go to the customer. A bill is generated, customer knows that this bill has been generated in his name. Two things happen. One is the information sharing, and more than that, it increases the relationship. Somewhere customer feels more, I mean the appearance of the company changes, finds to be more professional. Customer finds it more professional and everything is tracked in place with SMS. Same way we can configure an SMS template for sales register to send dispatch details. Here we just have to select that screen name saying sales register and send it to account. We can send SMS for pending bills also. When in bills receivable or bills payable, whichever screen. In receivables, let's say you want to remind all customers on their outstanding amount. Then you can configure a screen for screen bills receivable. Bills receivable summary. What will happen in bills receivable summary? I'll just create a sample template here also. Let's say bill outstanding reminder. Action SMS. Send SMS. In short, I can give this account name. Your total number of you can just mention the total number of bill due with us is this bills. and total outstanding is the amount or the account balance, whichever you can give. Bottom line, we can again give the company name. Or the company location name is the branch name, or you can just have the company name also. Let's say company location name and insert. So you get a summary saying at the bottom will be show as Max Enterprises. And you can send this to account and save. So we have integrated in two screens, for sales transaction save and for bill outstanding. Similarly, we can link it across all the screens. All the screen options are available here. Whenever there's a receipt happening from a customer, a thank you message can go to a customer saying thank you for making the payment. Your check is being deposited. Same way, when we make a payment to a supplier, a message can go to the supplier saying we have made a payment against or this much amount against this bill. So customers are also aware that okay, the payment is about to so been dispatched. Basically, all the updates could be done. It can even be done from purchase order screen, sales order screen, point of sale screen. Purchase order means whenever we are raising a purchase order to a supplier, so the owners or the purchase in charge person is in track that a PO has been raised, so they can take the respective action. Okay, so these are two screens which we have just temporarily configured here. Now we will just see a sample on. See, now when we go to this bills outstanding, outstanding reports, bills receivable, and we'll have to select the summary because we have connected with the summary report. See, automatically once we click summary, the SMS option has come. The two customers whose outstanding bills are, number of bills are also being shown, two bills and three bills. So when you click send SMS here, each of them will receive a message saying total number of bills, total amount due, and it request on making the payment at the earliest. This way more clarity exists, customer also aware that this much amount is due for this. And a weekly reminders like this could even increase your payment flow. Same way in the sales bill, I've given an ask confirmation. Let's say I just enter a Rajpuna Enterprises, I have mentioned name as Mr. Vinit. Let's say 10 pieces. And I just save this. So once the transaction is saved, it's showing you the template. It is with the invoice number 4 and invoice date, and you're just clicking send SMS here. If there's no ask confirmation, messages will go silently in the background and it says do you want to print. The same way SMS template has been designed, where we can see the impact of this. So you can go to this miscellaneous menu and okay, we'll have to log in once again. You'll get an SMS option here. I'll just have to re-log in once. So we just needed to re-log in once. You find an option here, SMS as well as email. Both these options are coming here. There are a few options available here. Based on the SMS alert module, you'll find some start SMS engine. What is the purpose here? Start SMS engine is nothing but it will start sending all the messages at the background in case if there's suddenly a power cut that has happened or you have sent messages and net went off. And later again when you're trying to start the system again, instead of typing the messages, because messages will remain in a queue in the system at the background, all the messages will get queued. If you are sending 1000 messages together, everything will remain queued and it will keep sending messages one after the other. In case if there is any termination of the software happens in between, then you can click the start engine again and it will start sending the messages which are in the queue. Update delivery status will update the SMS delivery status, whether it has been delivered, not delivered, generally the status delivery update takes little time. It doesn't happen immediately. So once we click this, it will automatically process the and find out the delivery status of each of the messages sent. SMS blacklist, here you can define a set of mobile numbers on which the messages should not be sent through the system. So if you define any mobile numbers here on the screen, just a simple option where you can just type the mobile number name and save it. So even if that is a customer and that mobile number is available in our database, through this messages will not go to that mobile number. So it will automatically drop out those numbers. This is one important report, SMS communication report. Now whatever SMS have been sent by the system will be shown here. You can just find out SMS for a particular date. Now see, when as per our sales bill, the sender ID max SW, the message has gone to this number and it has automatically changed, dear Mr. Vinith, Rajpuran Enterprises, Mumbai, last invoice number, invoice date, invoice amount, thank you, and max ERP. It has been picked, it has been sent, delivery status not updated, same way failed status is also not updated. Here you are finding two details here, which means it has taken two SMS, it's more than 160 characters. So it has occupied two credits, but the message has been sent on this date time. Okay. You can quickly filter out failed messages if you want, or unsent messages, by going to options. You can choose something for a particular vendor only if you want to see, or you want to see on the messages which have been failed. You can take this and apply, and then you can quickly reselect those failed messages and resend. Those options are also there. Okay. So this is one key report where you can find out complete history of all the messages sent to a particular contact. Now in case if you want to send SMS to external contacts, then we have an option here saying quick SMS. This option will help you send messages to any external contacts. If you have any database in Excel, or if you have your own set of friends whom you want to send messages to, just copy paste all the mobile numbers here, either comma separated or in separate line. You can have 10 digits number. Sorry, I think first one I have added more. Should be a 10 digits mobile number. See, whatever contacts that we enter in the system should not have +91 or 0 sign, I mean 0 at the prefix. Should just be purely 10 digits mobile number. You can just add all the mobile number either comma separated or in separate lines here. You can type your own message saying test message or whatever it is, and you can directly click send. And all the numbers will go. Yes, it will come. Okay. I'll just send a test message to our sales number. As well as the support number also, let's say. Now you find these two messages coming here. One has been picked, not sent. Second is not yet picked. The first one is sent, second is sent, everything is gone. These two messages has occupied one credit from us, from the SMS account. And those both messages would have come to our numbers. It will deliver very fast on D&D routes. Whether D&D is activated or not activated, on D&D route messages will get delivered. This will be the sender ID. We'll find Max Software SWS sender ID. Clear with the SMS communication. And in case if you want to send bulk SMS to your existing contacts, you can just go to this account list report. You can click show, or you can just filter your contacts and you can just select all and send SMS. Whichever has mobile number will get accumulated automatically here. All the mobile numbers of the contacts will come automatically. Here you can filter particular contacts of particular city. If you are traveling to, let's say, a particular state, Gujarat or something, only contacts of Gujarat should know that you are visiting there for the coming week. Or you can send some offer to particular area, particular city, particular street. You can filter as per the account group options available here. And directly type a message and send. Internal contacts, bulk messaging is possible. You can filter in any possible combination, and only to those contacts the messages will go. Same way, external contacts also you can send SMS. You can link SMS with every screen, every report, and you can send SMS to the account, to the admins, to the users, salesperson, and the supervisors. Apart from that, in case if the session management is, there's one more module called session management, in which once a user comes in for a retail outlet specifically, or all these fruits and vegetable stores or department stores, where a user one comes in, he will log into the system mentioning the denominations, as well as once he logs out for the day, or if there are multiple sessions in a day, like one user from morning 8 till 3, and then someone from 3 to 9. Then first user, once he closes, the owner receives or the manager receives a message saying the first user opening time, the total sales of the day, the split in the cash card, total quantity sold, total discount availed, and the closing time for the user. That one summary of his work of the day will be sent as an SMS if the SMS module is enabled along with the session management module. Okay. All this same thing can be configured for the email template also. Next we have the email template design. Same like SMS template design, we have an email template design where it's more over like MS Word interface, where you have all this option to mark it as bold, italic. Internally it will be sending, email is nothing but an HTML, hypertext markup language. It will be formatted internally as an HTML, it will be sent email. Same thing we have here, like let's say a thank you email, or you can just give sale thank you. Screen name, you can again give sale invoice. Action, save. Whom the message should go, admin account, salesperson, user. So let's say account. Should it ask confirmation? Again, inserting field option is there. Subject, you can just mention saying Max Enterprises. Any subject user can give, and then they can type dear Mr. and then they insert the field. Contact person. Of time if required, voucher number, voucher date. Something like this. And you can just save this template. This message will be sent through the default email gateway which we have designed for the admin user. If multiple users have multiple email accounts, like we have seen that sales user can have a separate email account, account user can have a separate email account. So whichever is the email configured, if current user is a sales user with the email account configured, the email will go with his account. If there's no account configured, then it will search for the admin user's email account. If it's there, it will send via that account. Otherwise, the mail will not be sent. Okay. So currently, we do not have any email account configured for the sales user. And anyhow, we are configured in the, we are logged in on the admin user. So I'll just enter one more bill saying, we'll take the Rajputana because I think email ID is entered. The customer should have their email ID entered. So we have some dummy email ID saying rajputana@gmail. We are just mentioning a transaction here. So first thing it's asking, do you want to send SMS? So I gave escape. And then it's asking, do you want to send email? I gave send email. And you want to print. So we can have silent email sent for all the screens at the background. We can configure a template and the messages will keep going directly. If we want and PDF to be attached automatically, let's say the print format of the email and the invoice should automatically be attached and it should be sent, then we even have one more option here where you can go to this configuration. Yes. So if we have the email template configured for a particular voucher type on save action, it will even send the email as well as it will attach the PDF format of that particular print voucher in that same email and it will send automatically. Same way if we configure a template for a SIP payment as well as for purchase order, sales order, whatever it is, it will automatically export the voucher details as a PDF as well as the sales invoice will export as PDF and it will send to the respective mail along, to the respective customers or the respective contact along with the other information. So the content would be the template that we have designed along with the PDF attachment of the voucher. In PDF also we have seen attachment, we have a print format and an export file format. So the export file format will be taken into consideration for exporting or creating the PDF template and that will be used for attachment for sending the mail. Same way we can just go to miscellaneous and we can find email where we can just again start email engine in case the mail has not went. Same way email blacklist where you can define the email IDs of the customers whom the message should not be sent using this software. If some customer complains and if they are disturbed with the SMS or emails, then you can just message them in the blacklist or mention them in the blacklist and the mails will not be sent to them. If before sending, it will always verify the blacklist first. If the email ID exists there, it will drop that. It will ignore that particular contact. In email communication report, you can find out what all emails have been sent from the software. So this one email which has been sent at this location by this user from this ID to this ID. Message type is email, no CC, no BCC, and the subject is the template subject that we have defined. It has been picked, it has been failed. It says failed. So maybe there's some configuration mistake on the email gateway. But if it's sent means you'll find it sent along with the send date time. Currently it has failed, the mail has not went. Okay. We can always test the email gateway also, like we have in the SMS gateway, where we have verified the amount of SMS that we had credits available. Same way in email setup in the users when we do email setup, there we have an option to test the email account first. And we search for an admin user here. This we have seen in the role and permission session where we can just give test email account. So always verify the email account first and then proceed with the sending of the messages or using utilization of the account. Otherwise, the mails will keep failing at the background. Maybe there's something missing here. Anyways, this configuration detail, whatever it is, has to be correct, accurate details, and accordingly, it will directly start sending the message. Mail. No, that is not required. Anyways, we've already seen this test in a separate session. Here, we just need to configure the correct details. Maybe I'm not having the correct information with me on this. So, email gateway setup, what all we have learned? Email gateway setup, SMS gateway setup, sending bulk SMS to the contacts, to external contacts, as well as integrating SMS, personalized SMS templates with different screens like sales, receipt payments, bills outstanding, sales register where we can send bulk messages to all the bills generated today and all the customers will receive that, dispatch details like LR number, LR dates, as well as outstanding payment reminders can be sent on a weekly basis. Same way we have even learned to design the email templates. And when we link an email template along with the contents, if it's linked to a particular voucher type save action, then it will even attach the PDF document of that particular voucher in the mail for the end user. So we even learn to configure the email gateway and test the email gateway before utilizing this feature. All this module is a part of Max Alerts. Max Alerts module, if it's enabled, then only you'll find all these options on the screen in the file menu. The SMS gateway, SMS template and email template design. All these options will come only when Max Alerts module is enabled. Okay, and so that's all with session 7. We have learned account list also. We can just filter all the internal contacts for different cities, states, and send bulk SMS. External, we have seen, and email and SMS communication report where you can find out the details of the mail sent or the SMS sent, whether failed, delivered, all the status. So that's all with this session. I'll stop here. Thanks a lot.